Hey, just getting set up right now. It's a little toasty in my garage right now. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna be painting some vinyl toys. I just released a brand new toy, just came in this week. It's not even for sale yet. So the idea is I'm gonna be painting them right now and then they're gonna go for sale. Sounds fun? I thought so, let's do it. So, my name is Jeff. I go by Bleeding Edges. I do BXE Buttons X Stacia Made with my wife, who is Stacia. And that's why we're taking over right now. If you saw the post we did earlier, you got a little bit of background on us. We make enamel pins, patches, stickers, shirts. We make socks now, too. I'm wearing them right now, but you can't see them. So we're talking about toys today. So I did a Kickstarter to get a toy called Dr. Plague When Made. So this is the first colorway, it's in black. It is a penguin that is also a plague doctor with a little bit of steampunk influence to it as well. For the Kickstarter, I had these colorways that I painted. Kind of, a little too much shine. So it's silver and red, good stuff. So the black ones, the unpainted ones, are going to be available on bxebuttons.com. This one was a Kickstarter exclusive, but I got two extras, so you got to hop to it. So I'm going to put these away for right now. And then, coming very soon, this is maybe first time I'm telling people this, the blue version right here, this is going to be Tenacious Toys, is going to be the exclusive blue vinyl. And they'll be unpainted. And then it's called Burnt Orange, but it just looks orange. It's just a cool orange. It's not like a vibrant orange. So this one will be available through Ophelia Toys exclusively. He's gonna do, I believe, 10 painted, 10 unpainted. I'm not sure when these two will be available. I'd imagine very soon. You should probably follow Tenacious Toys and Ophelia Toys, but also follow us, BXE Buttons, X Stacia Made. And my toys will be for sale once this live stream ends, basically. I'm going to turn my camera off, run inside, and they'll be available. So today, what we're doing, we got the Purple Rain Purple. This is going to be the first widely available color, along with the black, of course. But so we got purple here. It's a really nice shade of purple. And we're going to make it look like this. So we got white, we got black paint. And purple on purple, which is fun too. So if you guys got questions, I got answers. I'm gonna put a mask. There's gonna be a mask over my face shortly, so my voice may be a little bit muffled. I'm in my garage right now and it is very hot, so I'm gonna dab my head right there. Oh, so I brought a couple other things. This was my first vinyl toy that I did. This is called Bearito. It is a burrito, but it's also a bear. And it's a burrito. This one was 3 points of articulation, both arms. The waist moves too. It's about 5 inches tall, like trying to go for the fight figure scale. The two of them don't really, different universe. But so this is burrito. And when I did my walkthrough of the table, if you saw the IGTV video that I put up before, I talked about a collaboration with Studio Catoween. I didn't have the most recent pin yet then, but I have it right now. This is the Sam from the movie Trick or Treat. Sam is in some sort of wacky ass pajamas and he wants to kill you. And it's a take on the Slayer logo. We've done a series of these. This is the fifth one, I believe. So check that out if you're into horror movies. We do that series with them. And one other thing, my stepson and I do a YouTube channel. So if you want to check out Ned Listens Too, he listens to my like hardcore punk metal records and gives honest opinions. A lot of time he's a pretty funny kid. So we get into some shenanigans. There's a little bit of work being done on my house right now, so you're gonna see some people walking around and you may hear a saw. Ned is the man. I'm gonna turn my compressor on. It's really hard to put gloves on when it's hot and sweaty out, but I gotta get them tight, otherwise the fingers don't hit the fingers. Alright. We'll get there. Okay, so first color is going to be purple. I'm going to shake like a little ball, man, because they take a little rain. So I like to use a monster color. There's a lot of other airbrush. Hi, everybody, if you're just joining. I always test on my hand. There we go. It's definitely purple. Got a little bit away from me, so I'm just gonna wipe it real quick. Never happens. So we did some purple on the body and on the hat. I'm just going to paint four right now. I'm not sure how many I'm going to paint with. If anybody's got any questions about the toy, painting in general, we could talk. We could talk about enamel pins and other crap too. If you want to talk about, whatever you want to talk about, we could talk about it too. You're stuck with me for an hour. Thank you.
Yeah, the toy, here, let me take my mask off. It'd be able to hear me a little bit better.
Yeah. So, yeah, the toy is it's a penguin, but it's also a plague doctor. So, yes, it does have a plague mask on. It's a one-part vinyl. It's like a finger puppet. I'm just painting them right now.
And if you're just joining, they'll be for sale once this live stream ends at bxcbuttons.com. Thank you. Oh, I ran out of paint. That's why it's not coming out. Here we are, it's purple on purple. This is just kind of a subtle detail. I just do it. I've been doing it first in the scheme of things, so it's go over it. I'm just gonna check everything is good before I change my colors. Give it a little bit more paint if it needs it in any spots. Alright, and we're done with the purple. Just changing airbrush paint colors at the moment, so nothing too exciting. We'll be back at it in a sec. All right, so next color is white. White is going to be the face mask of the doctor. Hell yeah. Okay. Almost got away from me. We're good. Alright. Yeah. little tricky to get under the hat, so I have to kind of change the details. But in general, like, I try to work a little bit tight and loose, so you can kind of see the differences. So, you know, they're all a little different. This isn't some factory. You're literally in my garage in New Jersey on a hut. You really see the light brings it out. Cool. So I'm just going to check everything again, make sure I didn't miss anything. Thanks, Paul. Also, I'm gonna give
Mile High Sufubi a shout out right now. They made these toys. The molds are made in China, and then they're all made in America. Like, all the vinyl's pulled in America, but it's like pretty thin. I don't want to say it's Japanese quality, but you know, it's got a little squish to it. It's really cool. They came out great. Thanks again, Paul.
So I'm done with the white. I'm going to find a little spot right there. If you're looking to get vinyl toys made, never done it before, or just trying to... My connection keeps pausing. Go to Mile High Sufubi if you need a toy made. They're awesome. I've sent numerous people to them. I'm like their unofficial spokesmodel. No, I guess right now I am their spokesmodel, so there I am. All right, so white's all done. I'm just gonna clean up my brush, and then we're gonna do gold next. Says that somebody sent a request to be in my live video, but I don't know who you are, so sorry. Seems like it's lagging. Is that a problem for you guys? I don't know what it's doing. Maybe because I'm in my garage and the Wi-Fi is not great. Okay. So the gold always separates, so you gotta shake it good. Again, we are using Monster Color All right, let's do it. So the gold is going to go on the belt, the staff, and the eyes. I'll show you the cool thing about the staff in a bit. I'm going to do the loose stuff first. So we are currently painting vinyl toy Dr. Plaguin. We're going to make them all look like this. This is my test paint here. Dr. Plaguin is a plague doctor penguin. And once this live feed is over, they're going to go for sale. I find the metallic paints are a little thicker. Take a break for a sec. It is very hot out here. Whew, goodness. All right. Okay, now we got the fun part. So, we've got these paint masks here. These are made of copper, I think. And going to paint the paint. So you see how it lines up there? Alright, so this part makes my life so much easier. Grabbing this spray. And you see a good part of it. Airbrush stuck on my table. There we go. So they couldn't do it all as one piece, so you can kind of see it's just like, you know. Okay, so that's all for that one. Then we do the other side of the cane. Maybe I should do the top. Let me do the top. That way, just in case it's still a little bit wet, it's not going to smudge or anything. So, see, that did the top of the can. Then we gotta do the inner part of the cane. See right there. We're having appliances delivered right now.
Thank you.
Come on in. We have a special guest. Check it out. It's Stacia from Stacia Made.
How's it going?
It's going good.
Lots going on at the house.
So. Yeah, not a great day at the house today. Yeah, an overhead angle would be great, but this is all we got. Sorry. yeah, it's on the thing. It was like $40.
Yeah, where is it?
It's in my purse.
Okay. Thank you. I owe you.
No problem. So yeah, what I'll do is I'll angle it. Hey, it's Megazone. Megazone did the sculpting of this. So let me angle it down right at my fucking crotch. Can you guys see that a little bit better? Alright, so it's got a paint mask and you know, it means I don't have to be careful. There you go. To the staff of the cane. There you go. I smudged it. Oh, gotta do it again. One sec. Oh no. Okay. Fix that up good as new. No one will know. Oh, it looks like I forgot to paint eyes on some of these, so let me do those now before I put this paint. It's hard to get under that hat, but I do my best. I'm just giving every piece of gold another look to see if anything got messed up, and then before I clean it up. It's a little hard to see the comments at this angle, but I think it's...
Thank you.
Go with the guy. Okay, he's coming.
Yo, measure that. All
right, I'm coming in.
Switching to that.
What's up? I'm gonna take a break for a sec and drink from my glass. Okay.
Thanks. Yeah, the paint masks are awesome. I'd be kicking myself if I didn't get those, especially for the cane. That's that would never be that would never be clean. See his little tail, his feet, and the flippers, and the neck with black. This is a little tricky to do. You know, as opposed to doing the masks and stuff, this is just kind of on me to get it tight.
Yeah.
Pretty good. So, next step is the eyes. Perfect, every time. Mostly every time. It looks like that was the last one. I only set up to do four of these. I'm just going to give everything, before I put away my black, I'm going to give it a once over. It's pretty solid. There's a couple spots of the gold I may want to touch up later, but I'm not going to waste your time. These look good. Happy right there. That's pretty solid. So there we go. I'm just gonna clean up. It's probably a bad habit, but once I do the first wash of my airbrush, I always pour it back in. I feel like paint gets thicker over time. So if it, as time goes on, it gets diluted, that's totally fine by me. I lost my paper towel. Oh, I gotta get a new one. Okay. Done. Don't mind the noise outside.
Okay, so we're all done. So the purple Dr. Plague wins. They will be for sale. Give me 3 minutes, 5 minutes, or whatever. BXEbuttons.com, Dr. Plague win. I'm Bleeding Edges. Go to BXE Buttons X Station Made. Follow both of us. Again, BXEbuttons.com, and you'll be able to purchase these. If they sell out, I have a few extras to paint, maybe 5 more after that. But yeah, blanks painted, they'll be for sale. And I got a couple of, I think there's only 2 of the Kickstarter painted version in black. Thanks again for watching the feed. Really appreciate you guys, whoever stuck around. Oh, I got a mark on my nose. Appreciate everybody who stuck around and came in and out throughout the whole thing. Maybe we'll see you at DCon this year or next year. Who knows? All right, thanks again. Bye.